Yeah, I must have gone in the cave. Perhaps that deactivates the beam that comes out. I didn't actually see it in this game, but... anyway, let's get on with it. This could be our first little introduction boss. I probably activated a Sight of Grace. Oh, hang on, no, I didn't. But there's something in here, isn't there? Here we go, folks. Oh, I know what I was looking for. The wolf area. And I think that might be the next Stormfoot Catacombs we're at the minute. And that might be a little bit further along this wall, maybe. Cave. Side. Oh, shit. What am I doing? Right, am I all ready to go? Is this the... Oh, this is those gargoyle things, isn't it? I asked to talk to this chap. Oh, he's not saying... Oh, a proper death means returning to the Erdtree. Have patience until the time comes and the roots call to you. Right, I think these are those horrible little gremlin things. I thought you heard some of them. There they are, look. I think I used the bow and arrow on these before. That's right. I knew that was going to be one that jumps out, little bugger. I know these are buggers. Oh, they got that blood thing on them as well. I thought these don't feel any easier either. That wasn't too bad. I think you gotta keep going once you get hit on them. I can't remember which boss is in here. Is it that dog thing, but it looks like a cat? It's called dog something, isn't it? But it looks like bulldog or something. I can't remember what it is. I can't remember. I forget. I don't think we've got to activate this, haven't we? Locked by some contraption. Right, I remember. Does one of them have a bow and arrow or something? There we go. Yeah, there is. I thought there was. Bit of that sunshine. Is there another one down at the bottom? There he is. Little swine throwing stuff. Come on in. Come up here. Running off. I thought they chased you up the stairs. I don't know. Right. Is there a fake wall in here somewhere? I've got a feeling there might be, or I might be getting mixed up with something else. Got to get that bugger up there as well, don't we? Contraptions up there, the pulling lever, I do believe. Ah. There he is. Why is he not coming down? There we go. Is there another one? fucked that up, didn't I? What's that potato head thing, Dave? I remember seeing that before, but can we turn this off? There we go. Is it the next time round? I'm sure there's those green things reappear or something. Right, I can't remember where we go here. Same again. There they are, look, little swines. There's two of them up there. There's one that four altogether. Can't get through there. Shit, man. Actually, you can burn these buggers, can't you? If you time it right, but I'm not going to try that. Shit, man. I aggroed them both. Oh, there's more! Little fucktards. Ah, I can activate it now, can't I? Shit, man. Fuck. No! No! Oh, I could crush a grape. Hello, 16-bit, how's it going? I thought I was going to die then, just as you came into the room. They're a pain in the ass, aren't they, those little gremlins? Let's see if I can face that first starter boss. And 16-bits on Elden Ring 2. How you doing there, 16-bit? How many hours do you put into Elden Ring, 16-bit? Fancy Bandage said he's put around 1,000 hours into Elden Ring. I should imagine you probably put in quite a few hours. Here we go, right, there's one here as well, there we are, look. Is there another one in this room? Where's that crossbow bloke? Right, the lever's not here, it's somewhere else, I know. Grr. I've only got one flipping thing left. There we go. There, thing. Bit of that sunshine. Is there any more? I think there is in there. KG. How many hours you put into Elden Ring yourself? 16-bit. I'm not sure if I've asked you that before. Summoning spirits. With a spirit calling bell, you can use ashes to summon various spirits. Summoning typically consumes FP. You can only summon one type of spirit at a time. You cannot summon spirits during multiplayer. Right. I didn't realize we needed that bell. Right. Ooh, Wandering Noble's ashes. Great. Some bits are pretty good. Don't forget I've played Elden Ring before as well. So I'm not doing too badly in relation to the first time I played it. 300 hours. So far so good. But still need practice. Put that down there. I might have to sort everything out here shortly. How many hours you put into the... Have you played all the Dark Souls games then, 16-bit? I've only started the first one. Of course, I saw you playing that the other day, of course, the first Dark Souls. I want to work my way through. I'm sort of tempted to carry on going to like look at the graphics, because I want to see Dark Souls 3, see what the graphics are like on that. There he is. Sekiro. I want to play that as well at some point. Is there another one? So yeah, Souls games. I've only played a bit of Bloodborne, only about an hour or two on Dark Souls 1. Probably about 150 hours now on Demon Souls, and now about 80 hours on Elden Ring. There's little things that are starting to click a little bit better as well. Fighting mechanics, jumping and using the jump a little bit more. While fighting. Thing is, I've only got... What have I got here? Somewhere, a heavy door's opened. Yes, we know. 60 hours on each of the Dark Souls games. Should I go and try and fight this boss without any health? No. I'm gonna go back up there. 100 hours on Sekiro. How do you find Sekiro? Would you say... They say that's the hardest Souls game, don't they? Because you need to use the parry a lot more, don't you? He's got a bit of a delay, hasn't he? This one. This is the easiest boss in this game as well, isn't it? Innit, this is the easiest boss in this game, isn't it? So if I actually... I'll be happy if I do melee him, because I did cheese him in the last game, which I said before. So I need to practice all this melee stuff. I'm making excuses a bit, but me swords... I am getting used to the sword. Oh, Soldier of Godric, yeah. If you count him. Yeah, I said that last night, didn't I? He's still quite hard, this one, though, at this stage. Blunt weapons are better against stone crystal enemies. Yeah. I don't think I've got a blunt weapon on me, I don't think. At this stage... Right. Timing. This is what it's all about, isn't it? Timing! And that was bad timing. actually gets quite enjoyable once you kind of get the hang of it. In a sadomasochistic way. Oops, right. Kind of teaches, this boss kind of teaches, trying to teach you patience, isn't it? Hacking those pillars down. Right, get the fuck out. Oops, that easy. I might get me runes there. Belt braces. Come on, Mother Trucker. Yahoo! Back of the net. Get in there. Noble Sorcerer's Ashes. I'm pleased with that. I think that is the first boss I've beaten with just a sword and no help. Ever. Usually I cheese him. So that's the first one. Rock on, brothers and sisters.